All right, so we are going first. Let's take a look. So we do have one of our ley lines. No actual creature besides a potential Dryad Arbor and four lands. So I think I'm gonna mulligan this. We can do better potentially. This is also a four lander, but we have a Slippery Boggle. Not the best four lander, but I think we have to keep it. Rancor, yeah, we're pretty much in the business of topping, putting on top most auras that we would see at this point. Luckily, we have a Horizon Canopy, which can potentially find us some more gas. So let's see what we are up against here. Wooded Foothills for Blood Crypt. Interesting. So it looks to be Hollowine, most likely. I mean, almost certainly. All right, so that wasn't the worst for us. Unfortunately, we would have actually liked to keep one more of those auras, but we were not able to, so we're just gonna use the Rancor that we do have to start getting in there. And so our opponent did not have a Hollow one, or else they would have cast it on that last turn. So that part is good. I would suspect something like a Gurmag Angler on the next turn, potentially. Our opponent did not discard any Flamewing Phoenixes or Bloodghast, so that is kind of a win. And so it is Gurmag Angler as expected, and it's good here. We can't attack past it yet, though we do have the path. So I'm just gonna cash in the Horizon Canopy. And since we didn't draw anything, just kind of forced to path away the Gurmag. If we draw, we're really looking for something like a Daybreak Coronet would just be amazing. But really, most auras. Coronet would be the card that I don't think our opponent could answer for sure. Ethereal Armor also would be really nice. Now maybe our opponent has found a Hollow one. Yep, there it is. There's a Hollow one. And it looks like a follow-up play as well. Another Goblin Lore. Okay, now those Flamewake Phoenix and bang, bang. Another Hollow one. And with two Flamewake Phoenixes in the graveyard, that is very bad news. We really need something fast. That Hyena Umbra in the graveyard, we would love. Gonna have to be content with this Spider Umbra though. So I am going to cast it here. But our Slippery Boggle, really, we would love it to have first strike. There's so many enchantments in the deck that give it first strike. We just, have not drawn one. So now we're in a spot where we can block with it, but we're going to lose our Spider Umbra. We can also. Okay, so our opponent's actually going to hold back. So, in that case, pretty content to just take this hit. And I'm going to thin out the deck a little bit, search out that Dryad Arbor. Spirit Mantle is a great draw. One of the cards we were looking for. So now we can put it on our Boggle, and it essentially means our opponent has to kill us on the next turn, pretty much. Unless they have some sort of main deck answer, which is pretty unlikely. And it's also pretty unlikely that they can kill us without lightning bolts. Alright, there's one lightning bolt. So I shouldn't have said that. They still need multiple, like, blood gas plus lightning bolt. Would that do it? Yeah, I think blood gas plus lightning bolt. The fact that they're attacking, though, means that's a good sign, unless they have two more lightning bolts. Or brutality plus lightning bolt. But there's already two lightning bolts in the graveyard. So, yep, that's going to be the game. Sweet. It's timely Spirit Mantle. After having a pretty bad draw, to be honest, up until that point. So I'm going to take out the Ley Line. Sometimes you'll see Hollow Index board and Thought Seizes, but generally no. Path to Exile and Rest in Peace. This is a pretty good matchup. As you could tell, there's not that much to interact with a big hexproof creature. So I like these cards to come in. And in terms of sideboarding out another card, as weird as it is, based on that game, I actually like taking out a Spirit Mantle. Because we do have Griffspoon as another way to kind of provide a similar effect, and Spirit Mantle is a 2-mana card. It was great in that game, but that game was not normally how this matchup plays out. And this is quite a nice hand. So I'm going to keep it before we're able to, you know, Glade Cover Scout into multiple enchantments is basically everything that this deck is trying to do. Of course, there are Burning Inquiries, and there's some ways our opponent can mess it up, but Flameblade Adept is not one of them. We have the Coronet, so if we're able to, on turn 3, you know, gain back some life we may have lost early, that's going to be important. Sometimes these decks do have some edict effects, like Liliana of the Veil being one that we really, you know, don't want to see. Okay, there's the Burning Inquiry. We don't want to lose that land. So it looks like our opponent did discard a Bloodghast and a Flamewake Phoenix. So they can bring back the Flamewake Phoenix right here, which is kind of an issue, because we're taking 6, which we can't do anything about. Path is a good draw. So I'm going to get a Temple Garden here, because we need another white source for the potential of having the Coronet. We did lose the Coronet we had, though, which is unfortunate. So we're hoping to draw another one, which is why I'm getting the Temple Garden. I think we want to start getting aggressive, but we also are incentivized to hold up this Path to Exile, so I'm going to hold up the Path, hope to draw another lifelink effect, obviously. And sometimes Burning Inquiry does really mess up your draw, and that's exactly what happened with that Burning Inquiry our opponent cast, and it can be frustrating. Not gonna lie. Not like we have done anything wrong up to this point. But that's the nature of the Halloween deck. A lot of things happen a little bit randomly. So I'm just gonna get rid of the Flameblade Adept. It's hard to produce two blockers for a menace creature. And we can potentially defend with the Glade Cover, although we really don't want to be doing that. We want to be trying to be aggressive. So, unfortunately, we did not find the Daybreak Coronet there. But I think we want to try to present lethal next turn. So I'm gonna do that by rancoring up the Glade Cover Scout and putting Griffspoon on it. So this unfortunately we are still 1 point away from having lethal on the next turn, even with the Spider Umbra, but there's not really a better option than making this play. And then I'm just going to go ahead and cast this Glade Cover Scout. Getting the basic forest, that's going to allow us to potentially play around a Lightning Bolt, because Lightning Bolt does not just kill us now. So we have the Scout to block the Hollow One. Take four. Hope to draw any enchantment to put on our Glade Cover Scout for lethal. That's the plan. So we'll see if it works out. In these games, it's kind of like, all right, is there a way we could have gotten one additional point? Oh, wow. Yep. Well, nothing we could have done about this, so Lily's going to edict us. And that's for all intents and purposes, game over. Would not have got there. So let's go to a third game now. So we're on the play. It doesn't really change too much as far as strategy is concerned. Or sideboarding is concerned, actually. I'm just going to resubmit this. It does give us a better chance because it makes our 2-mana cards come down earlier. Pretty solid hand. I'm going to keep Scout into Spirit Dancer into Coronet. Obviously, we're still worried about cards our opponent could present. Burning Inquiry is one of the ways our opponent could just easily mess our hand up. Engineered Explosives, the Liliana, we already saw. But most of the cards in the Hollow One deck do not really interact with our game plan. So gonna get that Glade Cover Scout in there. And of course, if our opponent has a removal spell for the Spirit Dancer, that's gonna make it a little bit tougher on us. Flame Blade Adept, okay. So we're going to play that freshly drawn Razor Bridge Thicket. And I like just deploying the Course Spirit Dancer here, sort of forcing the issue. If our opponent does have removal, then we kind of go all in on the Glade Cover Scout with our Auras. But if our opponent doesn't have removal, then the Spirit Dancer, we can just kind of go crazy with that. And there's the Lightning Bolt. And the Burning Inquiry. Okay, so this time around, the Burning Inquiry was not nearly as devastating. Our opponent was able to get Bloodghast and Flamewake Phoenix in the graveyard, and is attacking for 5 here. But we have Coronet set up for this turn. The only way that this goes south for us is a Liliana. Or an Engineer Explosives, I should say. But I think we're supposed to go for it here. Normally, there are, you know, like one copy of Liliana of the Veil, maybe two. And we want to get the Coronet down because Burning Inquiry, if our opponent has more of those, could take the Coronet out of our hand. So I think, and the only way to get the Coronet down is by playing an Umbra and the Coronet. So this is the highest upside play. If our opponent now has an answer, it's going to suck. But the amount of answers are not that many. And now our life total is in a place where our opponent can't actually race us anymore. Okay, so that's pretty good news. Our opponent actually discarded a Liliana of the Veil here. So could have been freshly drawn. But in any case, that's the map.